Jean Massé.
For the best introduction to Marseille, you can spend less than 12 euro to buy a return ferry ticket out to the islands past some of the most fantastic attractions. There are hiking trails through the moonscape on the islands. If you're lucky, you can see wild puffins. I wasn't lucky. Although recognized as a city of culture in Europe, Marseille keeps its authentic port city vibe. It's a little bit boisterous, and it has great connections to the water. Folks behind me are sitting and feeding the fish while they eat lunch. There's actually quite large fish in the harbour, and they come right up to you to feed off you, so just something a little bit different. So if you do come to Marseille, come and feed the fish. This cathedral was originally established in the 12th century and then redeveloped as a basilica minor in 1896. But there's an even better one.
It's a really good walk from the port up to the basilica, but I'm almost there and I feel great.
Established in 1853, this basilica offers you panoramic views across the entire city of Marseille and the Mediterranean. It's absolutely spectacular. The building itself is beautiful. The garden behind it is quite plain and it's used for outdoor exercise activities. If you have time, go and find these two hidden gems I'm about to show you.
Going down into the metro, and we're going to use that to get to our next destination.
Corbusier's furniture designs are internationally famous. Here, you'll see his architecture for free. If you walk or drive a couple of blocks from the Corbusier building, you'll come across this incredible garden and beautiful building. I'm gonna go to the next one.
Thanks to my hiking meetup group, I know you can eat these. Outrageous street art greets you as you see this famous monument. Thinking of street art, I told you that Marseille still has its rough port city vibe. Here's an example of a fantastic attraction most tourists never see. This is a creative collective with music, art, and many other activities happening all the time. It's open to the public and it's really interesting. And it's bedtime in Marseille. I really hope you enjoyed seeing both the classic attractions and also some of the more unusual attractions in Marseille. I look forward to seeing you next time. Thanks for watching. You can walk from the Marseille airport to the train station. It takes you through an interesting sort of wild path if you use Google Maps. And the train costs €5.20. There's a ticket office at the train station and they were happy to help. This funky little Airbnb was just up the road from the central station. Next time, come hiking in Lagos.